Let's talk tennis.
Yes, you've been champing at the beats, so let's talk about this one.
Okay. Rafael Nadal, yeah, expectedly he won because no giants to slay. But then he went ahead 6-1, 6-3 against another Spaniard, also a left-hander.
Yes.
Talking about Albert Ramos Vinolas on Sunday. And it was just an easy one for him. Seeded fourth in the tournament, a 10th Roland Garros trophy that is actually, you know, waiting right now because this is his first ATP tour. Win is actually the first 1000 series actually, you know, winning since Barcelona. So it shows that work for him. Aramos, seeded 15 in this tournament, just wasn't up to that level that I wanted him. Nadal wasted about 3 break points in the second game. He tried to level that, talking about Ramos, and he leveled for 1-1, only for the clay court game to win the next 5 games. And of course, he bagged the opening set. So simple, 6-1. And the second one, it was all about Nadal, and he broke 4-3-2 in the second set. Ramos sent him back and long, and for Nadal, he was unstoppable. He went ahead to just clinch the best. So simple and easy.
Yeah, simple and easy. I mean, that's why he's the king of clay. For you remember, after he lost out to Roger Federer in that final, I think that was in Indian Wells or was it in Miami? Federer told him, don't worry, you're going to be fine. Just when the clay court season starts, you're going to kill it.
You've been charged.
And exactly, that's what we're saying. The first one of the year, Monte Carlo in Monaco, and Rafael Nadal has won his 10th Monte Carlo Masters title. No player in the Open era has ever done that, has won a particular tournament 10 times. So it's all about rewriting history for Rafael Nadal. 6-1, 6-3 in 76 minutes. That's how he defeated Albert Ramos in the final. And he's the first man in Open era to win 10 titles at a single tournament. That's massive. And he's also the first man to win 50 clay court titles. Cecilia,
rewriting history there.
I mean, there's no doubts at all.
The best.
That he is the best on clay ever.
Ever. Both open and.
Open and back in the days, right?
Back in the days. You just can't compete with
Nadal. You can, yeah. So, good one. I imagine Nadal right now, after losing 3 big finals, remember he lost Australian Open, he lost in Acapulco as well today, and he lost to Federer as well. And it's good to see him finally get over the line. And as a result of this win, Rafael Nadal is back in the top 5.
Aye.
Yeah, in the ATP rankings. Nadal is back in the top 5. Take a bow, Rafael Nadal. Let's see what he can do at the Barcelona Open. You still have the Madrid Open coming as well, too. So, Cecilia, it looks like...
Just keep taking it. Roger Federer is taking a break from play, so he's going to return in next Grand Slam, maybe.
Yeah, and those are the guys that are supposed to provide the steep opposition.
Which guys? I haven't seen
you know them
this season.
Yeah, what's going on?
In different form this season.
Murray, Djokovic,
both of them,
well.
No complaint of elbow injury. They came back after 5 weeks, and we're still not having it. Wawrinka, I really don't know what's wrong with him. In different form or lack of form, whatever, but he's not having injuries or anything, but I think Stan Wawrinka just don't want to step up. But this is clay. When you have Rafael Nadal, and clay courts happens to be a tournament where anybody can actually win, especially when you're so good.
Yeah,
the Spaniards are usually very good.
Yeah, when Nadal is not around.
Okay, when Nadal is not around.
But
right now you
that.
Have Nadal is playing all the clay courts. He said he's going to play in all the clay courts tournament this season. So, I mean, Djokovic and Andy Murray, okay, no chance for them.
Mm.
Let's talk about golf now.
Golf, yes.
Yeah, who is this man winning his very first PGA Tour after so many
Kevin
years?
Chappell. American was very decent at the U.S. Masters, and that's in Augusta where he tied for 7th. But he's gone one step further now. He's built on that particular momentum to win his first PGA Tour title. That's at Texas Open now. So Cecilia, we have a new kid on the block. But I mean, when you win your first PGA Tour title, I guess you can go by that tag. Kevin Chappell survived a huge test of nerve, as well as a final round charge from Brooks Koepka, as a clinch his maiden PGA Tour victory as at the Valero Texas Open. Chappell kept his composure to hole in the winning birdie putt from 8 feet on the 72nd green to snatch a one-shot win over Koepka.
What is going to jump to top 25 in the world rankings? So, which is really a cold one for him.
Good one for him, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is kind of interesting. Now, quickly, we'll talk about the IWF now.
Yes.
Okay. We knew it was always going to be difficult for Team Nigeria. We didn't really hear much about their preparations. The only thing we needed, okay, they were in the U.S. training, and from there, they're going to Bahamas.
Mm.
But then nothing happened. I mean, 2015 was wonderful, but 2017, nothing to write home about. That's the 4x400 meters women, Nigeria finishing seventh. USA won it, Poland second, Jamaica third, Great Britain and Northern Ireland were fourth. And for Nigeria, if you flip over, you will say it's seventh. Australia, Botswana, and France, of course, taking the last one. Nigeria just 2 points, but it's not a good one. But then, okay, yeah, that's the way it ended. 4x400 meters women in Bahamas, and that's how Nigeria just couldn't make anything out of it. Now, if you look at the 4x100 meters of women, they finished sixth in heat two. So at the end of the day, they couldn't even get to the final. And the names of the ladies who actually ran that, I was surprised that Blessing Okagbare wasn't there. But then that's something we need to find out from AFN, why she wasn't there, because she was listed as the lady that would lead the team. But unfortunately, she wasn't there. We have a listen, Lindley, her name is always very funny. They have Patience George, Ngona Undu, Jennifer Mandu, they were the ones who ran the race. And Dominic Duncan wasn't also there in the race. We'll go for a break now. We'll come back. I think Fire, we need to react to this.
Just a 60, 75.